Welcome. This video will guide you through the process of replacing O-rings in a Viking Universal Seal pump with an Oproguard seal. Consult the appropriate technical service manual before you begin for safety information. Tools required include a set of SAE Allen wrenches, a small screwdriver or cold chisel, a soft-headed hammer, a brass or a hardwood bar, hook-nose spanner wrench, box-end wrenches, an O-ring pick, as well as O-ring lubricant or grease, and a grease gun. The lubricant and grease should be food grade if the pump is to be used on food products like chocolate. The O-ring replacement kit includes the two inner static sleeve O-rings, the two inner dynamic gland O-rings, an outer static gland O-ring, a seal installation sleeve, gland nuts, washers, bolts, two jack bolts for removing the Oproguard seal, and a head gasket in case the head and rotor shaft must be removed. First, bend up the tang on the lock washer. Insert the brass bar into the top port to prevent the rotation of the rotor and shaft. Use the hook nose spanner to remove the lock nut and lock washer. Remove the brass bar. Loosen the two Allen head set screws on the face of the bearing housing. Remove the bearing housing. Use a 2-pin spanner wrench if needed. Remove the bearing spacer collar. Remove the half-round rings, except on these sizes, which do not use them. Loosen the set screws holding the Oproguard sleeve to the shaft. Loosen the gland nuts, securing the Oproguard seal in the bracket, and remove the T-bolts. Thread the jack bolts into the tapped holes at the top and bottom of the gland, and use a wrench to help press the guard seal out of the bracket, alternating back and forth between jack bolts. Remove the Oproguard seal. Remove the sleeve from the seal gland. Remove the two inner static O-rings from the sleeve, as well as the two inner dynamic O-rings and one outer static O-ring from the gland. Clean as much old grease and product from the sleeve and gland as possible, taking care not to nick the surfaces. The remainder of this video illustrates the process of replacing O-rings and reinstalling the Oproguard seal. Before installing the seal, examine the shaft for wear. Excessive wear at the O-ring locations may require replacement of the rotor shaft to ensure a good seal. It is also possible to shim the Oproguard seal slightly to adjust the location of O-rings on the shaft. Install the three set screws into the sleeve. Do not over-tighten to allow the sleeve to slide down the shaft. Lubricate the O-rings and Oproguard sleeve thoroughly with O-ring lubricant or grease. Install two inner static O-rings in the sleeve grooves. Install two inner dynamic O-rings and one outer static O-ring in the grooves of the gland. Install the sleeve into the gland. The set screws on the sleeve must be on the opposite side of the outer static O-ring of the gland. Slide the seal installation sleeve, if provided, over the shaft. The LS size pump does not use one. Install the sleeve and gland assembly onto the shaft and through the bearing housing opening. The gland side with outer static O-ring must be installed onto the shaft first. Be careful not to allow the keyway or threads on the shaft to contact an O-ring. These may be taped over to ensure that O-rings aren't cut by sharp edges. Install the seal gland flush against the mounting face of the pump bracket. Remove the seal installation sleeve. Now replace the half-round rings and bearing spacer collar. Replace the bearing housing. Tighten the lock nut and bend a tang from the washer into the slot to lock the bearing to the shaft. Now set the end clearance. Your Viking distributor can provide the correct settings. A separate video, Setting End Clearance, which provides more detail on this procedure, is available on the Viking Pump website. After setting the end clearance, tighten the bearing housing set screws and test rotation. To avoid air pockets while greasing, orient the gland with the grease fitting near the bottom and the grease relief fitting near the top of the gland. Secure the seal gland to the bracket using the bolts, washers, and nuts provided in the O-ring replacement kit. Tighten both nuts on the gland bolts completely. Position the sleeve so the face of the gland is flush with the edge of the groove in the sleeve. Tighten the three set screws on the sleeve evenly to ensure the sleeve is concentric and secure to the shaft. Remove the grease relief fitting from the gland. Now grease the gland until grease comes out of the open hole where the grease relief fitting will go. After cleaning the excess grease off the gland, use thread sealant to insert the grease relief fitting into the open hole in the gland and tighten. Re-grease the gland until sufficient grease comes out of the grease relief fitting to ensure that all air has been purged. Rotating the shaft while greasing will help remove trapped air. Regular re-greasing is required, and discoloration of grease coming out of the relief fitting is an indication that O-rings may need to be replaced. Your pump is now ready to be reinstalled. Thank you for watching.